unlimited cloud DVR storage, and recording saved for up to 9 months. Here are 10 more things you need to know about YouTube TV's DVR. Number 1. New ways to organize your DVR. This is the YouTube TV library from a TV set. You see filters for your DVR on the left side of the screen. New in your library, most watched, and scheduled are right there at the top, but for the options further down, there are additional ways to organize content. For example, I clicked on shows, and in the upper right corner, there are options to reorder recordings in this category. Examples include alphabetical order, trending, and most popular. Let's keep it moving. Number 2, add programs to your library. Just look for the plus symbol to add programs to your DVR. From the YouTube TV home screen, this entire section is dedicated to content that you may want to add to your DVR. And while watching live TV, click down twice on your remote and you see the plus sign again. Now I'm on the live guide, and when you select a program that is airing sometime in the future, the Add to Library option appears. When in doubt, there is always the search feature. Select a result and add to library. This is the view from a TV set, but you can also add programs to your library from a web browser or the mobile app. Click on the three dots next to a program and find the plus symbol. I didn't mention this before, but you can also tap the bell icon if you want to be notified when a program airs live. Those notifications will go straight to your cell phone. Number 3, stop recordings. Removing programs from your library is just as easy as adding them. Watch here. Simply click the check mark by the program name, and that will stop current and future recordings of that program. But this is important. YouTube TV says that programs already recorded will be available until they expire, which could be up to 9 months from now. And unfortunately, I don't know of any way to delete single episodes. Number 4, more on recording options and limitations. When you are recording a series, all new episodes and reruns are recorded. There is no way to record a single episode. But for sports, you can record a single game or multiple games. For example, you can add your favorite teams. I chose the Washington Nationals, and YouTube TV will record all games that air on its networks. Or set recordings for entire leagues, like the NFL, and you see options here to record groups of games, including the playoffs. If you want to record a one-off event, whether that is sports, entertainment, or news, just search for it and add to your library, because in that case, you can record just the single event. Number 5, mark as watched. Since YouTube TV does not have options to record or delete single episodes, the Mark as Watched feature will come in handy. It's available from a computer or phone as of this recording, so I'm on a computer for this demonstration. From my library, I selected a program, House Hunters, and then found the episode to mark as watched. It's as simple as tapping the three dots and then marking the episode as watched. Now watch as I return to the library from my TV set, and you see that the episode is marked watched, so I know to skip it in the future. There is also a red bar along the bottom of the thumbnail to indicate that the program has been watched. Number 6, avoid commercials. Skipping the ads is one of the main reasons to use a DVR in the first place, and that's why it is so important for you to select the DVR version, not VOD, if the option on your screen is ever presented to you. VOD stands for Video On Demand, and that version will have ads that you can't skip. You see them on this timeline. But when you record a program, a DVR version is created, and that will let you fast forward through the ads in almost all cases. But know this, ads are not removed from the recording automatically. You will still need to click fast forward on your remote to scroll through the ad breaks. We continue with number 7, options for playback. For most recordings, you'll probably want to start watching from the very beginning so you don't miss a moment of the show or movie. But in the case of live sports or a news program, you may want to join it live. I'm on the library screen again, and as I make my way down to the scheduled section, you see programs that are being recorded right now. And ESPN SportsCenter is one of them. When you select a recording that's airing live, in this case SportsCenter, YouTube TV gives you the flexibility to join live or start from beginning. And even if you select Start from Beginning, you can always jump ahead to Live using the Fast Forward. And another option, for select sporting events that are added to your library, use the Key Plays playback feature to get caught up on the action. Number 8, adding a program that has already started. And ideally, you want to add programs to your library before they air, but we all know that is not always possible. If you add a program to your library that is in progress, YouTube TV begins recording at the time that you added it to the library. You can see from this example on the screen. And you probably guessed what that means. You may not record the entire show or movie. But good news here, YouTube TV says that if a rerun of a particular recording airs in the future, the full program will be available to watch, not just the partial recording. Number 9, keep a separate library. Don't want to share your DVR with other members of your household? Well, there is a solution for that. It's called family sharing, and I'm back on my computer to show you this feature. From the settings, the family manager, which is just the primary account holder, can invite other people in the house to share the YouTube TV membership. And these family members will get their own viewing preferences and library. YouTube TV requires a Google account to sign in, so the people who you share your membership with must also have Gmail. We've made it to number 10, download recordings for offline viewing. So if you want to download recordings to your mobile device to watch when you don't have an internet connection, well, that is only available with an upgrade. This feature is part of YouTube TV's 4K Plus add-on, not the base plan. Other features that you get with the upgrade include 4K on select content and unlimited streams on your home network. Give this video a like if it was helpful, and keep watching for more YouTube TV tips and tricks.